Hey, what's going on, everybody? Dr. Sean J. Harris here at Generational Wealth Academy. Hey, I had a question asked to me the other day about if I had $300,000, Sean, what should I do with it? Should I pay off a home? Should I pay off debt or anything like that? And my recommendation was, of course, everybody's financial layout and portfolio is a little bit different, but I wouldn't just pay off a house with $300,000 that you came upon, whether it's through whatever, 401k, or just came across money you want to pay off a house. It wouldn't quite make good financial sense just to pay off the house, and here's why. And keep in mind, a lot of times we get in the mindset of thinking, well, if I got the money, go ahead and pay it off, and that's something I never have to worry about again as far as paying off the house. But let's examine it a little further. If you had $300,000 to pay off a $300,000 house, for an example, okay, it's paid for. So you got to pay property taxes, utilities, etc., things like that. But here's the financial aspect that we have to look at. With that same $300,000, you could subdivide that and pay $20,000 on a down payment on 15 more houses. Or you could pay $10,000 down payment on 30 different houses. Now, with each one of those houses, you now have tax advantages with that. So now you can see how your wealth begins to extrapolate. Again, in real estate, it's not necessarily about how many properties you have per se, but it's how many doors you have. So at that same $300,000, instead of buying those 30 different homes or properties, or even 15 different properties, I would most likely invest in one property, in a hotel, or an apartment building that has multiple doors. Because of what that does, it reduces my liability and responsibilities, but still be able to capitalize and make the money because you're operating on doors and not roofs. See, if I had 15 different houses or 30 different houses, that's 30 different water heaters I have to worry about. That's 30 different plumbing concerns I have to worry about. That's 30 different roofs I have to concern myself with. But if I have one hotel with 30 different doors, that's a better play financially and time-wise freedom for me. So again, when you come across large sums of money, is it wise just to pay something off? It depends. It just depends on your particular outlay. But overall, I would say I would diversify that money a little bit and have it start working for you. Because money just sitting by itself or just paying off something is not doing any good. You paid off the house, it's not a big benefit or asset to you when you can use that money as a tool to then start building other assets. That's what money is used for. Money is, the purpose of money is to build and buy assets. So I hope that helped out there for anyone who's in that situation where you have a lump sum of money but don't quite know what to do with it, whether you should pay off something. But my number one thing I would recommend to you is put in a position where you can create or buy a asset that can become a income producing asset. That's one thing, just buy an asset. You can say, hey, I paid off the house. Technically, that was an asset, kind of, sort of. You bought a car for $300,000. You went out and bought a Bentley. Well, that's still a liability. So I would position myself again to deploy those funds, deploy that capital to where it can make more money for you. All right, guys, I'm Dr. Sean J. Harris. I hope that was a major impact to you. Make impact and make money.